Hello, everyone, and welcome to this week's weekly What's Up on Envato Tutsa's photo and video section. My name is Shruti Shekhar. Every week, we tell you a roundup of what is going to happen this week. And today, I have Kezz Bracey all the way from Victoria in Australia to tell me a little bit about her course this week on making the shift to Affinity Photo. I know this week's Coffee Break course is on live filters and inpainting. So, Kezz, tell me a little bit about this course. I know it's split up into two sections. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so in this course, it's a little bit different to some of the other material that we're covering throughout the overall Make the Switch to Affinity Photo series. Sometimes we're covering things that are just a little different to other things you might have used in different applications. But in this case, we're going to be covering material that's pretty unique to Affinity Photo. So the first of those areas is we're going to be looking at live filters. So if you've used Photoshop before, or if you've used any other graphics application, you have probably worked with filters. And in most cases, filters are a destructive technique. So if you apply, say, for example, a blur to something in your piece, then that blur will be applied permanently to whatever you're working on. So if later you want to adjust the way the blur looks or you want to undo it completely, you may not have the option. So with live filters, you have the option to continue working with whatever filters you've applied in a live way throughout the course of your work. So you might apply a blur filter, and then later you can come back and you can change the settings of that blur. So you change the way it looks, or you can turn it on and off at any time that you want. So we're going to be going through how you can use those live filters and just a little bit of guidance on how to get familiar with them. And the second part that we're going to be looking at is using Affinity Photo's inpainting tool. So Affinity Photo's inpainting tool is a really fantastic tool for working with photos, for doing photo manipulation or photo touch-ups, and it's kind of like magic. This is a tool that's, in all sincerity, it is so effective at what it does that when I first saw the video demonstration of it, I actually didn't believe that it could possibly do what I'd seen in the video. So I tried it out for myself, and I was blown away. It's incredibly effective. So what it does is it will let you highlight any object that's in a photograph. You just highlight that object and then it will make that object disappear as though it was never even in your image. So say, for example, there's a coffee mug on a table. You just highlight that coffee mug and it will make that coffee mug disappear and it will just look like a clean table.
Wait, just like that? Like you can just erase it?
Just like that. So it's if you've ever worked with the clone stamp tool in Photoshop and painstakingly removed an object from a scene using the clone stamp tool, it's a little bit like that, but it's completely automated. So all you need to do is just highlight the object and then Affinity Photo will take care of all of those steps, all those little steps that might have taken you 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, it will just take care of all of those steps automatically for you.
Amazing. Okay, so honestly, I feel like I need to watch this course now because I think the clone stamp is honestly the worst thing on the planet. I really want to learn how to do this now. So tell me a little bit on that being said, you know, how difficult is it on a scale of 1 to 10? Because, I mean, if you're just starting out in photography, is it something that you can work with? Is it pretty easy for a beginner? Or do you need to know a little bit about photography and photo editing to do this course?
Well, I would say that with the inpainting tool on a difficulty level of 1 to 10, in some cases, it'll be a 1. It'll be easy. It can depend on the exact composition of your image, but sometimes you'll just highlight the object and just bang, it's just gone. And it really, like I couldn't imagine a way that it could be made any easier. Sometimes you might need to do a little tiny bit more work and then I would give that maybe a 3 or 4 working with the inpainting tool.
But it's pretty easy for the most part though.
Yeah, in my opinion, yes, definitely. With the live filters, using the live filters is, I would also say that that's quite easy to pick up how to find a live filter in the UI and how to apply it to your work. that's a little bit more hard, more difficult to give an exact sort of numerical rating of its difficulty, because all the light filters are different to one another. So the Gaussian blur will be different to the motion blur. So they're all, some have only a few settings that you can change and some have more settings.
The rest of the week is pretty jam-packed as well, with a bunch of things going on. On Monday, I have Andrew Childress, who's going to tell us in 60 seconds what Adobe Lightroom is. On Tuesday, Amy Touchette continues her street photography series and will tell us how to use and see daylight creatively. On Wednesday, Harry Guinness will tell us a little bit about what HDR is and will tell us how to create high dynamic range photographs. He's back again on Thursday with another unexpected underwater portrait. And on Friday, I've got Don Osterhoff, who's going to test McFun's Tonality CK in a fun way to do black and white conversation. That's all we have for this week's Weekly What's Up. I'll talk to you guys next week. Bye.